October 14, 2025 marks the day Windows 10 ends its support. Well, it's just for all the versions that aren't LTSC. What is that supposed to mean? It sounds a lot like NTSC, but that's a different thing. LTSC basically means long-term servicing channel, which means you don't need to update the OS at all. So yeah, you won't be bombarded by those annoying updates all the time. But even then, unless you're a prod Mac or Linux user, in the latter's case you're based as fuck, this sounds like really bad news. Windows 10 has been a very popular operating system lately, kinda like Windows XP of the late 2010s. Whoa, I made it sound like I'm insulting Windows XP, even if I hardly ever used it. Well, as I have been using Windows 10 since the same year it was released until 2023, I've had quite a lot of problems with the Windows version. When you compare it to Windows 7, you can see that 7 was a lot more fun to use. It defined my childhood and has always been my personal favorite Windows operating system, kinda like how you're comparing GTA 5 with GTA 3, or Fiona and Cake with the OG Adventure Time. I loved that damn show, man. By the way, I'm not trying to slander Windows 10 or anything, but I'm just sharing some of my experiences with it. Anyways, one of the biggest problems I've had with Windows 10 is how it sometimes updates without even telling you or anything. Like, I would turn my computer off and then all of a sudden it fucking updates. You never even fucking told me about it! That's like ordering a burger but they put tomatoes on it despite ordering one that isn't supposed to have them in the first place. So much for trying to eat healthy while eating something that isn't even healthy to begin with. I mean, yeah, updates are indeed important, but when Windows 10 does it without your consent, then it's really annoying. Never really had that problem with Windows 11 though. Then there's another problem with Windows 10. Bloatware. I mean, I don't have a problem with Minecraft, but who the fuck ever plays Candy Crush on a computer? I don't even know if that game is popular anymore, but holy hell were there so many Candy Crush clones that make Adidas knockoffs look original. Ever met anyone who wore Adidos? But anyways, if you ever played Candy Crush of all things on a PC, then you're a fucking madman that deserves a shoutout. I mean, on Windows 11 you can literally download mobile apps, which I kinda find a bit more convenient but also unnecessary at the same time. What's that for, people without phones? Oh wait, that actually sounds like a good thing considering how addicted many people are to smartphones. I mean, would you ever use mobile apps on a computer frequently when you have your phone right next to you? But wait, we're talking about Windows 10 here. And there's also redundant software on Windows 10, with the same problem being passed down on Windows 11. I mean, Windows 8 basically started this, but that's a failed OS that people didn't like very much. Maybe removing the start button wasn't a great idea after all. It's like Costco becoming a gas station company out of nowhere and then everybody gets confused. Or like Taylor Swift becoming a rapper and then Swifties get confused. This is a joke, by the way, please don't attack me. Okay, to be real, why even create settings when you literally have control panel? And the fuck is Paint 3D when you have Microsoft Paint? Oh wait, that's discontinued already? Was it that irrelevant that nobody talked about it at all? And what's Fresh Paint? Is that like a superior version of Microsoft Paint? Looks fun. But leaving the problems aside, and despite the fact that Windows 10 looks more bland compared to 7, there are a lot of good things about the OS, which make it somewhat nostalgic, to the point that it survived for a very long time like XP and 7. The wallpaper is actually really cool, along with this trailer that I was obsessed with as a 9-year-old back then. Yeah, I was weird as fuck. But let's get to the point. First of all, what does it mean for a Windows version to end support? It basically just means Microsoft would no longer provide updates for the Windows version. This makes it much more vulnerable to viruses, malware, and whatnot. But does this mean you can still use Windows 10 until you can find the appropriate time to finally update to Windows 11? Technically, yes. You can still use it with a third-party antivirus as long as it's up to date. Although this has a lot of risks. I mean, with the likes of Avast or Norton, you shouldn't have a big problem. I'm obviously not recommending shitty antivirus softwares from malicious sources, though. But should you do this for a far longer term? Yeah, maybe just ask your computer doctor somewhere. You see, operating systems have their own expiration dates. Microsoft, Apple, and the likes don't want you to be using the same operating system for the rest of your life, basically, and they feel the need to end support once the succeeding operating systems become increasingly popular. Seriously, when do you ever see somebody using Windows 1.0? That too from 1985. This was before Lady Gaga was born. It's crazy. I mean, things are getting so crazy that you might find a grandpa still using Windows 95 on his old computer at his house near the Gobi Desert or something. I wonder what that'll be like. Back in the days, it was a pain in the ass to install a new Windows operating system. Just imagine you're using good old Windows 98 in 2007, refusing to update. But then you need to do it since it died by that point. So you go to the store and pay around $400 for a Vista, but then all of a sudden your PC's too old to handle it, so it crashes like crazy. But now you can just simply jump from Windows 10 to 11 for free as if it's parkour or something. You no longer need to buy a physical copy like humans used to do. Yes, pun intended. But Windows 11 has its fair share of problems. From this Bioware Doxa to this ChatGPT knockoff that nobody uses. So even when Windows 10 is officially dead, you can still use Windows 10 for as long as you want because fuck Windows 11. Especially if you're somebody whose computer has a 32-bit processor. In that case, you'll have to buy a new computer because Microsoft is shit. In that case, you can download the LTSC version of Windows 10 and have that OS forever. Until 2032, that is. It's still like, what, 7 years? I'll literally be 26 by that point. Already feeling old as fuck though. Speaking of 26, you can also download Windows 10's ESU version, which you can use until 2026, which is already less than 3 months away. In businesses and schools, Windows 10 is still usable until 2028. But even then, the school I go to still uses Windows 7, 5 years after its support ended. Based as fuck. In fact, nearly 10% of computers worldwide have Windows 7 as the Windows version as of right now. Windows 10 has been the most popular Windows version until being overtaken by 11 recently, as 10 lies on its deathbed. Well, not really. Since there are people who still use Windows XP as of today, shout out to you if you're one of them. What's that? You don't want to use Windows anymore? Say no more! Just switch to a different operating system like Linux or something, although there will be challenges as it's a completely new operating system, and you'll have to use a compatibility system or a virtual machine to use all the Windows apps you're used to using. Or you can switch to Mac, which I personally detest. Sorry to all Mac users, by the way. Or what if I want to install macOS on my non-Mac PC? Will Apple send hitmen against me? I don't think so. But anyway, there are already a shit ton of tutorials showing you how to do exactly that. Or I have a better idea. North Korea's Red Star OS, that is their answer to the imperialist Windows. Yes, you can actually somehow install that even outside of North Korea. I'm sure Kim would really love that. Or fuck it, I'll just make up my own operating system, once I reach like 1 million subscribers in 6 months, of course. Nah, I was clearly joking. How can someone who hardly knows how to code even have the ability to do that? I don't even have a proper job for fuck's sake. So yeah, even if Windows 10 is officially dead, its legacy lives on. I mean, its support ended just now and it's still a very popular Windows version, so people wouldn't just install it immediately. Even if I'm using Windows 11, I'm not saying that Windows 11 is that good, but not very bad either. I mean, Windows 11 is actually less minimalistic than Windows 10, in which everything is flat. The 2020 update looks a lot more promising, but I haven't really used that, so I can't tell if it's actually better. Also, here's another thing. Windows 10 was actually supposed to be the last version of Windows, as Microsoft originally intended to turn it into a service with new versions and updates being released in an indefinite period. Basically meaning that it could have used Windows 10 even in 2050. Hell, The Simpsons would also be running by that point. But as Windows 11 was released in 2021, they just went and abandoned that idea. I already made a video on Windows 11 all the way before its official release, but I privated that as I found many of my old videos cringe. Please don't watch my old videos, I swear to God. So what about the users who are already using Windows 11? Well, they would just deal with it and keep using it until Windows 12 gets released in like 2034 or something. If World War 3 doesn't happen, that is. Some would probably say fuck it and downgrade to Windows 10's LTSC or ESC versions, or better yet, just go back to the glorious days of Windows fucking 1.0. Actually, never mind, Windows XP should probably be the furthest back we should go to. For all the Frugal era fans, Vista and 7 should be the way to go. But I really want Microsoft to make Windows 12 as awesome as Windows 7 was because it's not only for the nostalgia, but I want to bake some cakes in Purple Place like I used to. Anyway, that's all for this video. Please like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys when I have the opportunity to do so. And as always, peace.